Hey, this is Al Dawson from Earache Records, and we are actually celebrating our 30th year this year. So we're going to talk about some behind the scenes moments of some of the classic records that came out on Earache. Deicide was the first band on Roadrunner to ever fulfill their contract. They had an 8-album deal, and they were the first band to do those 8 albums, and they were free agents. So I got stuck talking to Steve and Glenn on the phone a lot. We got on really great and all this sort of thing, and we discussed what we wanted to do as far as a deal with them, and they were all into it. And I said, well, you know what? That's all good, but you need to come down to Florida and meet us face to face so we can get a feel for who, because you know, you could be some dork in a suit and tie or whatever, they don't know. But I get to Tampa, and to me it was like redneck heaven, you know what I'm saying? Like it was beautiful women, great weather, cheap drinks and all this sort of thing. So we're at a hotel, and this is probably, I think maybe MapQuest existed, but no one had like GPS on their phones or, you know, GPS in the cars at this point. We check into the hotel and we call Steve, and he goes, all right, what you need to do is you need to get on this highway here, take a right there and shoot up this way. But it's like about 45 minutes north of Tampa. So, okay, weird, but all right. You know, I thought we're meeting him in Tampa, you know, so we get in the car and we navigate it. And he's described it like, turn right at the supermarket. Like, there's a supermarket, turn right. And somehow we found his house. So we get to Steve's house. And we all get on great. And he's like, well, where's Glenn? He's like, well, no, he's going to meet us somewhere else. Like, okay, weird. So we get in Steve's Hummer. And we drive another probably 45 minutes north of them or whatever. You know, the chain Hooters, you know, with the girls in the short shorts and all this sort of thing. This is like an independent version of Hooters, a local thing. And no joke, it was probably 8 of the hottest girls you ever saw in your life. And there's 4 on either side. You had to run the gauntlet to sort of come into this place. And there's Glenn with his Harley out the front, like, well, hey, what's up? And we'd go in, like, hi, boys. And we're like, oh, my God, this is redneck heaven. So I grabbed the menu, and I'm like, Glenn, what do you want to eat? It's on me. Let's eat. He's like, I didn't come here to eat. I come here to drink. I'm like, all right, now you're talking my language. So we end up drinking, and we end up going to some other nefarious types of clubs. Then, you know, Glenn's like, actually, I have to leave. And he's on his Harley, like, whoa, whatever, right? So we end up back at Steve's place. And bear in mind, we only met the guys like 8 hours beforehand, whatever. And Steve's pretty buff sort of guy. I'm like, oh, so you work out. And he had like a whole room, like a gym set up in his house. So what's up with that? And he's like, well, you know, me and my girl were coming back from the beach one day. We got jumped by 10 guys and beat up and everything. Because after that, I said, never again. So, you know, he started pumping iron and lifting weights and all that. I'm like, that's a good story. And keep in mind, we're completely wasted. He goes, I also have this. And he reaches under his couch and he pulls out an AR-15. And he gives it to my drunken sales guy, Garrett. He's like, here. He's like, oh, like, no, no, like drunk with a gun. No, no, put it down. And he starts bringing out all his weapons and everything else. And yeah, we end up staying at his place till 4 a.m, trying to drive back. And Garrett's like, I'm like, what are you doing? And he's like, I'm seeing double. If I cover one eye, I can see good. So, I mean, I do not condone drink driving, but when it comes to you got to drink with Deicide, you got to drink with Deicide. And basically after that, they're like, you guys got the deal. And that's how it happened. It was all about drinking with Deicide, you know.